I feel like it's Keystone Cops out there.
I need to give you guys some straight lines to run.
You see it too.
Yeah. Well, he does a lot of refusals. He stalls out a lot, and I'll give you some exercises that help him move more.
Oh my God.
After everybody goes, I'll give you some stuff.
Good girl. Do it again and try not to leave it here.
Okay.
Good girl. Yay! Everyone's rewarding so much more. You're closing the happiness. Thank you. Thank you. You guys, I'm going to have a bunch of obstacle boot camp classes next week.
Nice.
Woo! That was just a bad line. I don't think you need to get that close to the double. Sure, you went all the way in the middle, but I don't think that you need to with this dog. So actually, comes around. Go jump, and then plant your feet till you see your nose come around, and then see how clear you are of this. But if you go all the way in here, you are now wasting your dog to get ahead. Not a good plan. Like with Moby, what I would suggest when we do the beginning is he comes over, you rotate, and you tell him, jump, and then you're going to throw the reward out for him. So that he, and you don't do it like this. Go jump, so that you don't have to go in there. Like, he needs to get rewarded more for driving ahead.
Okay.
And not with food thrown on the floor, because then he's just going to hunt for food. So you could use this thing with food in it.
Okay. I've got one of those.
Okay, you should use it. All right, you do the whole thing again. And you don't go so close to the double. Good girl. Look at that muscle.
Yeah, it's like just like a cannonball with legs. It's a great dog. Nice.
That was a second. She'd spell that a beat longer, right? To let her dog see it. Because she's a really handy focused dog. Tunnel. Say it. Yay! All right, that's all I got to do. You did good.